Well, we're joined by Yuki Tatsumi, a senior associate of the East Asia program at the Stimson Center in Washington. Ms. Tatsumi, thanks so much for joining us. It does look like a very strange choice. The timing here, I mean, it's been 7 years since a Japanese prime minister visited the shrine. It was guaranteed to inflame tensions, which are already high. Even Washington has been critical of Mr. Abe's decision to visit the shrine. So why did Mr. Abe choose now to go?
Well, I think I'm just as puzzled by everybody else for this, the timing of this particular visit. Only reasoning that I can come up with is primarily domestic driven. Mr. Abe had to spend a lot of his political capital this past year over very controversial issues, such as Japan's participation over TPP and very recently a passage of the National Classified Information Protection Law. And as he looks toward 2014, he has even more politically difficult and frankly unpopular agenda on his plate for it in his relation to Japanese voters. And the main one is the anticipated the consumption tax hikes in spring. And then also he has to start working on the pension reform as well. And as I said, neither of these items are very, very politically popular. And I think in order for him to weather that, this unpopular agenda, I thought my only thing is that he perhaps tried to secure his support base within his party and broadly amongst the voters. And his solid support comes from the conservative side of the society and also as within his party.
Okay, so a domestic decision, a very high stakes decision. I mean, it's interesting that the strongest ally and the ally that Tokyo most needs, of course, is Washington. Washington's very critical of this. And this will obviously play into the hands of hardliners in China, won't it? I mean, they've already been beating the drum for increasing a military confrontation in the East China Sea. Hasn't Mr. Abe played into their hands?
Well, that's why I think like myself, many of the analysts outside the government are scratching our heads and questioning the timing of his visit. This day, particular day, does fall onto his first anniversary since he came back to the office last year's December. And if you read his statement that he issued right after the visit, quite literally, he really wanted to pay the visit to the shrine on that the first anniversary to progress report, give a progress report, so to speak. However, like you said, this was a really high-stake diplomatic issue, and it did already draw a very critical reaction from U.S. State Department. So it is very confusing time for him to visit. But Yes, go ahead.
Yeah, just if I can just ask, I just want to ask, what does this do? How does this change, if at all, the national debate in Japan at the moment about the constitutional changes which are being considered, allowing Japanese military to play a bigger role in global peacekeeping, for example, the pacifist constitution? Does this change the debate here?
I think it does have some effect to the debate, unfortunately. I think my concern is that his steamrolling of the national secrecy law earlier this month and this visit made a lot of people in the middle in the Japanese society very unsure about Mr. Abe's personal intentions for these policies. So I do think that could dampen the debate a little bit.
Okay, all right. Well, thank you very much for that, Yuki Tatsumi, with the Stimson Center on East Asia Policy in Washington. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.